Today we are going to introduce you to the basics of the CommandFusion GUI Designer software. GUI Designer is a Windows application that we use to develop graphical user interfaces for our iViewer application. GUI Designer is a powerful tool that allows you to develop very simple or an amazingly powerful interface that can be utilized with almost any control system on the market today. The only limit to GUI Designer is your imagination. GUI Designer is available from the CommandFusion website. First, you need to make sure that you have the Microsoft .NET 3.5 framework installed. It is important to make sure that you have the .NET 3.5 Service Pack 1 installed, as the .NET framework is not backwards compatible with GUI Designer. After you have downloaded GUI Designer, run the .exe file and install it as you would any other Windows program. Here we have an example of an advanced GUI that has been designed to control Xbox Media Center. Today we'll be working on a simple GUI on an iPhone to control power on, volume up and volume down on a television. When you first open up GUI Designer, you will see this screen. There are six basic parts of the GUI Designer program that are present when you start it up. The Projects tree is where all pages and subpages for your project are shown. The Theme Manager is where you define the themes that will be used for all objects in your GUI. The Theme Library allows you to use predefined themes within your projects. These themes can be created and shared by anyone. At the moment, it is a manual process, but there are plans to make sharing easier in the future. The System Manager is where you create and manage the communications with your external systems, including commands, macros, and feedback passing within your GUI project. The toolbar allows for quick selection of some of the most commonly used tools in GUI Designer, and the workspace, which is where pages open and you will do the main work on your GUI. For this guide, we will create a very simple GUI on an iPhone. It will control power, volume up, and volume down. The first step is to create a new project. To do this, click on the New Project button on the toolbar, then type in your project's file name. The file will not actually be created until you save your project. This will then bring up the Project Properties dialog. Enter a project name and designer name, both are optional. The Asset folder is where project assets such as images and sounds will be stored. By default, this is set to the same folder as the project file. We recommend you create a new folder for each project so that all files for each project are nicely separated. The page size is where you choose what device the GUI will be displayed on. Choose an iOS device or one of the preset resolutions. You can also set a custom size if required. For this project, we will choose the iPhone setting. The Control System, Global Token Manager, and Script Manager sections are not important for basic features and will be covered in a future video. Next, click OK. Now we need to create some pages and subpages. A page occupies the full screen and contains GUI objects such as buttons and text. A subpage is a user-definable size that can be placed anywhere within a page. An example of a subpage might be a volume bar that you want to reuse across multiple pages. To create a page, click the Create New Page button on the toolbar. This creates a page called Startup by default in the project tree. Under the page, you have each orientation for the page. You can edit the contents of each orientation. If you leave one of the orientations empty, then the GUI will be locked in the orientation which contains GUI objects. To create a subpage, click the Create New Subpage button on the toolbar. This brings up the Subpage Properties dialog. Give the subpage a name, a background theme if required, by default it will be transparent, then choose the size required for the subpage. We won't be using subpages in this guide, but it will be covered in a future video. So now you can see that we have a page in the project tree. Before we add any objects to the page, we need to create some themes that our objects will use. In this case, we will use a pre-made theme from the library. It's a new one called Gravity. Go to the Theme Library and choose the theme you want to use. Click on Backgrounds and choose the Portrait background and drag it to the Theme Manager. It will automatically be put in the correct theme category for your project and any necessary images will be copied to your project's directory. We will use the same button theme for all functions in this project, so drag the appropriate button to the Theme Manager. The text shown in the theme preview is just an example and can be edited to suit when used in your project. In the Projects tree, double-click the page orientation you want to edit. We will only be using the portrait mode in this project. Now we want to assign the page a background theme. Drag the background theme from the Theme Manager onto your open page. Next, drag the button onto the page. Repeat this two times so we have a total of three buttons. we want the buttons to be neatly aligned, so click the Marquee tool from the toolbar and select the three buttons. Then click the Align Horizontal Centers tool and the Align Horizontal Center of Page tool. To space our buttons evenly, we can also click the Distribute Evenly Vertically tool. Now our buttons are neatly aligned. The next task is to label the buttons, so the user knows what button does what. Double-click on the button to bring up the Button Properties window. Add the button text into the text field. And tick Simulate Feedback. This tells the button to go into a press state even when there is no feedback. You can also use the Text Assign tool to quickly edit the button text. Volume up and volume down. We can select multiple buttons by holding Shift and clicking each button, then right click and hit Simulation Mode to quickly set both buttons to Simulation Mode. Now we need to tell the GUI how it is going to control the TV and add some commands to assign to the buttons. In the System Manager window, click Add System. This brings up the System Properties window where we define the communication properties for the device we want to connect and send commands to. In our case, we are using a CommandFusion LAN bridge to control a TV via RS-232. We need to add a system name, we will use the TCP protocol, and the IP address of our LAN bridge will be 192.168.0.10. The default port of the LAN bridge to route data straight to the onboard RS-232 port is 10208. Leave all other settings as default. In the System Manager window, select the system you just added and click Add Command. In the Command Properties box, type in the command name and the command value, which is obtained from your hardware's documentation. The command value is the data that will be sent to the system. Do this for the rest of the commands required. Volume up and the command. Volume down and the command. When you have done this, simply drag each command to its relevant button. The power command to the power button, the volume down command to the volume down button, and the volume up command to the volume up button. Now save your GUI. We are now ready to upload the GUI to our device. In the File menu, click on Upload Service. Click Start. This will start a web server that iViewer will use to download your GUI project onto your iOS device. Take note of the URL shown on the screen. Now we need to go into iViewer settings on your device. Enter the GUI file URL as shown in your GUIDesigner upload service window, including the IP address and the port number. Make sure that the Reload GUI Layout and Reload GUI Assets are both on. This forces iViewer to attempt a GUI reload, making sure that the new GUI is loaded onto the device. Multitasking should also be off to ensure that the app is fully closed when not being used, so it will attempt to reload your GUI project on each launch. Once your GUI is tested and there are no more changes required, you can change the settings back and it will load the GUI from the cache from the device instead. Now close the Settings app and launch iViewer. It will load the GUI onto your device, and there you have it, the GUI you just designed. Now you can press the buttons and see if the commands are working as you intended. For troubleshooting, you should first check the system properties in the System Manager to ensure your communication settings and command values are all correct.